The big four banks have finally relented and decided to pass on the full interest rate cut to their borrowers. For more on the political implications of this, we are joined by our Parliament House reporter, Amanda Hart, live from Canberra. Amanda, Treasurer Wayne Swan applied a lot of pressure on the banks on this issue. No doubt he'll now be taking credit for the cuts being passed on.
Yeah, well, you can bet your bottom dollar on that one, Ron. The government really does need to get as much mileage out of this as it possibly can, considering it does have a number of bungles in different areas. So it will be pushing it as much as it has, or as it certainly can. Now, Wayne Swan certainly has been putting pressure on the banks, as you mentioned. He'd been using some pretty tough language. So in their point of view, it's good that this has happened, as it is for homeowners as well. However, there is a spanner in the works. Now, the ANZ Bank is almost thumbing its nose at the government, saying that it's going to wait 10 days after the Reserve Bank makes any kind of rates announcement to whether it passes on any interest rate cut or rise for that matter as well. Let's have a listen to the Treasurer's reaction to that this morning.
We'll fight tooth and nail for families and small businesses. That's why we've fought so hard to get these changes in competition policy into law. The ANZ, like all banks, will be judged to the extent that they're seen to be competitive by their customers.
Wayne Swan might have been called the world's greatest treasurer, but he's the world's least authoritative treasurer here in this country.
Amanda, we're also hearing a bit of scuttle around the corridors this morning of a possible reshuffle.
Yeah, Ron, rumours of a Christmas cull. Now, these rumours have been going around the gallery pretty much since the ALP National Conference. And what's believed to have happened is that the Attorney General, Robert McClellan, is expected to announce that he won't contest the next election. And Junior Minister Nick Sherry is also believed to be taking some time off as well. Of course, this would spark a cabinet reshuffle. One person that really is vying for a cabinet position is Bill Shorten. And some sources say that he will actually get it. It should be remembered, of course, he was one of the so-called faceless men that got rid of Rudd and installed Gillard. That then brings the next question. What does happen to Kevin Rudd? It's no secret that there are pretty high tensions between the Prime Minister and the Foreign Minister. Now, the opposition says that one or both of them need to go. You can't have them both in cabinet. Let's have a listen now.
What the government needs is a policy reshuffle. The government's policies are the problem here. They can change the faces all they like. They can shuffle the deck all they like. But every time they're going to pull out a joker.
They are matters which are entirely for the Prime Minister.
Now, reshuffling the cabinet will no doubt leave some people with their noses out of joint. And of course, that's the last thing that Julia Gillard needs at the moment.
Amanda, thank you. Amanda Hart reporting from us live from Parliament House in Canberra.